Hello guys and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. In the previous tutorial, we discussed about the list comprehension, we discussed about the definition as well as syntax. In this tutorial, we'll discuss few examples for list comprehension. So the first example is if you want to add or multiply some number to the list. So for that, first I'll take one list called num. And here I'll take all integer number, okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so now I want to multiply value 10 to each element of list num. That is nothing but 1 into 10, 2 into 10, 3 into 10 and 4 into 10, okay? So what I'll do is I'll write 10 into num, okay? 10 multiply num and I'll enter. And here we can see we got this output. Okay, here in Python, this 10 into num will be treated as 10 times num. So it will print 1, 2, 3, 4, the element of num list 10 times. Here we can see 1, 2, this is third time, this is fourth, this is 5, 6, 7 here, and 8, 9, and 10, right? Then how to multiply value 10 to each element of list. For this we can use list comprehension. So first we need to write the brackets. Next here I need to write the expression. So I'll write my expression like this, x multiply 10, okay, for x in list num, okay, and I'll enter. Okay, sorry, syntax error. So we need to write like this and enter. Here we can see the output 10, 20, 30, 40, right? Okay, so this is the first example. Okay, so the next example is if you want to change the case of alphabets or words, then you can use list comprehension. For example, I'll take one list called words and here I'll take one string hello, I'll take one character A, okay, here we can see all the elements are in lowercase letter, but if you want to change the case of these elements, then you can use list comprehension like this. So here I'll need to mention x dot upper function. Next, for x in words, okay, and here we can see all the elements are in uppercase letter now. In the same way, you can convert the uppercase letter to lowercase letter, okay. So this is my second example. Next, the third example is, if there is a string which contains alphabets as well as numbers, and if you want to extract only numbers or alphabets, then we can use list comprehension. For example, I take one string called str1. Okay, so I'll take my string as Amul 112334. So this is my string, okay? Here this string contains alphabets as well as numbers. Now if you want to extract number from this string, then we can use list comprehension like this. So first here I'll write x for x in str1 if x dot is digit. And if now I enter, here we can see all the numbers are extracted. Okay, now if you want to extract the alphabets from this string, then you can do that by using same method. So here instead of isDigit function, we need to use isAlpha. Okay, and if I enter, here we can see it will extract all the alphabets from this string. Okay, so next we can apply this list comprehension on the nested list. That is, Okay, so list 1 is a nested list, that is it contains list within the list. Now if I want to extract first element of each nested list, that is 1, 4 and character A, then I can use list comprehension for that. X of 0 for x in list 1. And here we can see the output. Next, we can apply this list comprehension on the functions. So for example, if I define a function called square, this function will find out the square of the numbers, okay? So it will return x multiply x. Okay, so this is my function. Next, we can apply list comprehension on this function. So for that, here square of x for x in range, so it will print squares of all the number from 1 to 10. So here we can see 1 square 2 square 3 square 4 square 5 square 6 square 7 square 8 square 9 square and 10 square. Okay, so this is how we can apply list comprehension on the function. Next, using list comprehension, we can add to list. For example, I'll take to list like this. Okay, so this is my list. And now I'll write list comprehension for x in A, for y in B. Okay, so I'll enter and here we can see the output. It will add first 1 to 10, next 1 to 1, so we get 2 here, next 1 to 6, so we'll get 7. After that, it will add 2, 10, that is 12. Next, it will add 2 and 1, so we got 3. Next, 2 and 6, we got 8. Next, it will add 3 to 10, so 13. So next 3 to 1, so 4. Next 3 to 6, so that's why 9. Next it will add 4 to list B, so 4, 10, 14, 4, 1, 5 and 4, 6, 10. Okay, so we got output like this. Next, if you want to add the first element of one list to the first element of second list, second element of one list to the second element of second list, then we can do that. So to add like that, first we'll assume the length of both list is same. So here I'll take one list called C and I'll take 4 elements here. I'll take 1, 2, 3, 4 only. So here I'll add list A and list C. Okay. And here list comprehension, here inside this square bracket, I need to mention A of I plus C of I. Here I'm adding A and C for I in range 0 to length of A. So here both length of A and C are equal. So we can mention length of A or length of C. Okay. Enter. Here we can see the output 2, 4, 6, 8. It will add 1 plus 1, next 2 plus 2, next 3 plus 3, next 4 plus 4. So we got output like this. So, okay, so these are the few examples for list comprehension in Python. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll meet you in next class. Till then, take care.